Hi, how do you run Android on your Orange Pi 5? Let's dive right into it. What do we need in the first place? Obviously, your Orange Pi 5, SD card, your PC to prepare the SD card, and SD card reader. That's it.
First, head over to www.orangepi.org. Hit that Orange Pi 5 banner, then download, scroll down, and click on the Android image. Open the Android 12 folder by double-clicking it, then TF card image and right-click the Orange Pi image without the LCD if you're not using a device with touchscreen and hit download. Okay, that's the image. Now we need to download a tool to prepare our SD card and burn that image to it. Head to the main Orange Pi downloads page and open the official tools link. Download this Android image writing tool SDDisk tool and extract it on your computer. Now here is the first stupid thing. This tool's language is by default set to Chinese and we need to change that to be able to work with it. So open this config.ini file with a text editor of your choice and change the line selected equals 1 to selected equals 2. Save the file and close it. Now you can start the tool and it will be in kinda okay English. So set the removable disk to your SD card and check the SD boot option. Click on firmware and navigate to the downloaded extracted Android image. The file should end in .img. Hit open and then create and wait. Okay, the message says creating upgrade disk okay, that's fine. Now you can eject the card and put it into your Orange Pi. Connect your display keyboard and mouse and start it. You will see this nice boot screen and will end up here. It looks fine, but it kinda isn't. There's no Google Play Store on this device by default. And there is only so much you can do without the biggest app store on the platform. So we need to fix this right away. How? Let me show you. Let's start by opening this screen by dragging your finger or mouse from top left corner. Tap the cogwheel to open settings, scroll down, open about tablet option, again scroll down and tap build number option like 6 times until you see this message, you are now a developer. Good job, I bet you didn't know you're a developer. Okay, now open the web browser, that's the icon with the cloud. And search for Magisk Manager. Scroll down and hit download Magisk app. Close this ad and wait a few seconds. Allow access to files on your device. Obviously it needs to save the file. Open the notification area from the top left corner and hit the magisk.apk file. Go to settings and enable the installation of unknown apps and hit install. Open Magisk and hit install. And select direct install. Let's go. Wait until it finishes and reboot the device. Okay, here we go again. Now we need something called Magisk GApps. GApps stands for Google Apps, as you might have guessed. Pick this SourceForge link and accept. Go to files, Android 12 L Alpha, 17.10.2022, and download the basic version. Try to download anyway. You see it's downloading magiskgapps.bin. Let's wait for him to finish. Now what we need to do is to rename this file. It should not have a .bin extension. I wonder why it does. Open files, go downloads, right click on the file and choose rename. And rename it to magiskgapps.zip. Head back to Magisk app, close this warning and open the modules tab. Install from storage, burger menu, Orange Pi 5, download and double click the Magisk GApps zip and reboot once again. Okay, here we are. Open the apps and you will see this message saying this device isn't Play Protect certified. That's another thing we need to solve. Tap the message and then learn more. It will take you to Google support page, scroll down and pick the option device isn't certified. Again, scroll down and click on the link register your device. Sign in with your Google account, As you can see, we need to fill here the Google Services Framework Android ID. What the hell is it? Fair question, but we will solve this too. Open a new tab in your browser and look for APK Pure. Open it and search Device ID. Download this Device ID app, install it and run it. It will tell you what your device ID is in a hexadecimal code. Hit copy to clipboard and open another tab in your browser and search for hexadecimal to decimal converter. This first one should be fine. Paste your copied hexa code by hitting Ctrl V or Command V on your computer and hit convert. Now copy the decimal number by hitting Ctrl C, head over to the Google Support tab and paste this number into the Google Services Framework Android ID field. Check if you're by any chance a robot, and if not, hit register. And you should see this device registered message. That's it. And now you need to wait for Google to register your device. It could take up to 30 minutes. In my case, I think I needed to wait for like 20 minutes. After that, you reboot your device and the message about plate protected certified device will be gone. Now we can open our apps and launch Google Play, sign in and enjoy ourselves. I will of course install YouTube as the first app, but feel free to do whatever floats your boat.
I hope this tutorial helped you. If it did, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. And until next time, enjoy your pie. See you!